Hi guys, this is Mina, and welcome to my second video on SQL constraints. Constraints are used to specify rules for data in a table in order to restrict the data that can be entered into a table. This means that if we have a constraint on a column or a table, and there is any violation of the constraint, then the data cannot be entered into a table. The action gets aborted. This is important in relational database because it ensures the accuracy and reliability of the data that are entered in a table. The most common constraints used in SQL are the not null, unique, primary key, foreign key, check, and default constraints. All of these constraints can be specified at the time of table creation or after a table has been created, using the alter table statement. In my previous video, we talked about the not null constraints. Today, we are going to discuss the unique constraints. This is a constraint that ensures that each row for a column has a different value. It does not permit the entering of duplicate values in each row for a column. Like the not null constraint, many columns in a table can have the unique constraint. And also, when you set a unique constraint on a column, it automatically creates a non-clustered index on that column. We will discuss indexes in a future video. But for now, let's move on to our SQL Server Management Studio and try the unique constraint out. In our SQL Server Management Studio, I'll go to New Query and select the database that we will be working in. I've created a database called Tutorials, so I'll select that. Under Object Explorer, we can go to Databases, and this is our Tutorials database. I'll go to Tables, and I have one table here called People. In my query editor, I would paste the syntax for creating a table here. And I'm going to create a table called People2. And in this table, I'm going to demonstrate how to enforce the unique constraint. If you want to learn how to create a table, feel free to click on the link in my description section to watch my video on how to create tables. All right. So the easiest way to create a unique constraint on a table is to go to that column and type the word unique. And that's it. Another way to create a unique constraint on a column is to type the word unique and into rounded bracket provide the name of the column. So I'm going to create a unique constraint on the last name, colon. And that's it. If I execute this command, I'm going to have two columns with two unique constraints. I did not provide any name for these two unique constraints. So which means that the SQL Server Management Studio will automatically provide a name for these unique constraints that I've created. If I want to explicitly give a name to the constraints, then I can use the syntax constraint, provide the name of the constraint, and then I can specify the constraint and what column do I want to specify the constraint on. First name, colon, and close the bracket. Don't forget to provide a comma here. This will create another constraint on the first name, colon, and this constraint will have a name, UN people2. So I can go ahead and execute this command. Command has been completed successfully. Let's refresh our database. Go to Tables, and this is the table we've just created. I'll click on the plus sign, go to Columns, and these are the columns that we've created. To see our unique constraints, I'll click on the plus sign beside Keys, and there we have it. As I mentioned, the first two unique constraints that were created on the ID and last name columns were given a name by the management system itself. But the one that I explicitly provided a name for is this one. So you can either allow Management Studio to give a name to your constraint by using these two options, or you can specify a name for your unique constraint using the constraint syntax. If you want to see which of these constraints belong to which column, we can right-click on the table, go to Design. In the Design view, right-click on one of the columns and go to Indexes and Keys. Under Indexes and Keys, you can still see all these unique constraints that we've created. The UN People 2 index has been selected. And if we look in this box, we can see that it refers to the column first name. If we click on the second one, it refers to the ID column, and this one refers to the last name column. So that's how you can see which unique constraint belongs to which column. So I'll close this design view and go back to my query editor window. Here I'm going to demonstrate how to create unique constraint using the alter table statement. So the syntax is you type out the word alter, the word table, and then you provide the name of the table, and then you type add what type of constraints you want to add, unique constraint, and what column are you going to specify this constraint on. Let's do it on the age column. If I execute this command, the age column will also have a unique constraint, and here, as you can see, I did not specify any name for my unique constraint. So again, the SQL Server management software will give it a name. So I'll execute this command completed successfully. If I refresh the keys, you should see that one more key has been created, which is the unique constraint that have been created on the age column. If you want to specify a name using the alter statement, you type out the word alter, the word table, the name of the table, people2table, and then you add constraint. Add constraint, and then you provide the name of the constraint. And what constraint are we going to specify? It's unique, and it's going to be on the email column. If I execute this command, email column will also have the unique constraint set on it. Refresh your keys, and this is the unique constraint that we just created. In order to drop a constraint, you can use the alter statement to do that, and it's simply type out the word alter, table, the name of the table, and then you drop constraint, and then you provide the name of the constraint. Let's drop this constraint on the first name column. If I execute this command completed successfully, it means that this constraint no longer exists. And this constraint was specified on the first name column. So the first name is no longer a unique column. If I refresh and go to keys, this constraint, it's gone. So guys, this is how to specify unique constraint whilst creating a table, and you can specify it using the alter statement after the table has been created, and you can also use the alter statement to drop a constraint from a column in a table. Thank you so much for watching this video, and see you in my next one where we will talk about the primary key constraints. Stay safe and bye bye.